بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We thank Him for granting us the tawfiq and the ability to participate in today's gathering, auspicious gathering full of barakah and blessings, inshaAllah. These gatherings are the gatherings of salawat ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. InshaAllah, Shaykh Zakir just mentioned that we'll be doing our Isha Salah here.
Before Isha Salah, inshaAllah, in the masjid. If everybody returns, inshaAllah, there'll be food for everybody here, inshaAllah.
So just quickly, we don't have too much time, inshaAllah, before Salat al-Isha. Just a small few, just short few minutes reminder. I mean, I was ordered and instructed by Shaykh Zakir that I say a few words. So, as I mentioned, that these gatherings, alhamdulillah, full of barakah and blessings. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we make dhikr. We just read this dhikr that is La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah alayhi salatullah. Salawat and blessings on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We read Habib Umar al-Diyaul Lami' bi-dhikr al-Mawlid al-Nabi Shafi', which is a very beautiful compilation. And we also ended with one of the great chapters, probably the best chapters of the Burda, even though it may be considered to be one of the most controversial ones. But this is why there's beauty in it, because it is the best chapter of the Burda, in which the author, Imam al-Busiri rahimahullah, he is making his tawassul through the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya akram al-khalqi mali man aludhu bihi. The noblest of the creation, who is there for me to turn to besides you? Which is, we're talking to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and using his intermediary and his tawassul. And of course, ultimately, it's, you know, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this, alhamdulillah, that's a very beautiful chapter of the Burda. There's a hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam which comes in mind. One of the companions, I think Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam كان يسمي لنا أسماء. كان يسمي لنا نفسه أسماء. He would himself describe his names to the companions. He would tell them, inform them what his names are. And then he said, he would say, Ana Muhammad wa Ana Ahmad. My name is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My name is Ahmad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa Ana al-Muqaffi. I am the last of the prophets. The Muqaffi is the one who is the final, comes after everybody else. And then he said, Wa Ana Nabiyu Tawba. I am the prophet of repentance. Wa Ana Nabiyu Rahma. And I am the prophet of mercy. And this Prophet of Mercy, in another hadith, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's a beautiful hadith, one of my favorite hadiths, where he said, بُعِثْتُ رَحْمَةً مُهْدَات. It looked beautiful the way the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described himself. Like we hear, بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I was sent to perfect, noble character. In this hadith he said, بُعِثْتُ رَحْمَةً مُهْدَات. I have been sent as a mercy which is gifted to you. Beautiful wording. Not just that I am sent to you as a mercy. Like in the Quran, Allah says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have not sent you except as a source of mercy for the alameen, for mankind, not just for Muslims. Remember, that's very important. It's not وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Allah sent the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam as a source of mercy to the whole of humanity. And in this hadith he said, إِن بُعِثْتُ رَحْمَةً مُهْدَاتْ. In another hadith, إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَحْمَةٌ مُهْدَاتْ. I am a mercy that is gifted to you. In other words, there's three parties involved here. In other words, when something's gifted, you have the wahib and you have the mawhub lahu, and the item that is being gifted. Normally when we gift something to someone. Here when he said, I am a source, I am a mercy that is gifted to you, who is giving the gift? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gifting. We are the recipients of this gift, and the gift is the mercy of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's a beautiful hadith. Because he is full of mercy and it's a gift. So we have to appreciate when someone gives us something, we need to appreciate that gift. And we need to really take care of that gift. If someone gives us something and you know, somebody gives you a bottle of itar, and they see you straight away that you've just given it to somebody else, that's, by the way, you shouldn't do that. People don't think of these small things. Someone gives you a gift of itar, and the person just gave you that gift and you straight away gave it to somebody else in his presence, that's not good adab. Because he thinks, I've given him something and he's not even caring. Even if you want to give it to somebody else, give it later. If you don't appreciate the gift given by someone, then they will feel offended. If we don't appreciate the gift which is the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Allah will feel offended. So this is something really we need to take care of, that this is a gift to us, and it's the gift is rahmah, mercy, and we need to appreciate it, and we need to spread this rahmah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's the way of appreciating. Appreciating is to spread that rahmah. When you have that gift, so we need to appreciate it, and appreciation comes about if we spread that rahmah, that mercy of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam to everybody around us. Our family members, our relatives, our associates, our work colleagues, our friends, our neighbors, Muslims, non-Muslims, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, animals, everybody. That's our duty, especially living in the West. Our duty is to spread that rahmah and mercy of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam to everybody around us. And if we do that, then that will mean that we have truly appreciated that gift which Allah has, you know, granted us. And in that way, inshallah, we will be successful in this world as well as in the next one, inshallah. And with this, I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases in our love for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah enable us, give us the tawfiq to act in accordance with the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Very important that we bring the life of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our lives. From his shama'il, from his khuluq, from his character, from his attributes, from his good qualities, noble qualities, to the way he prayed, to the way he fasted, the way he interacted with people, the way he carried out his business transactions, the way he dealt with his family members, everything. You know, we can't pick and choose from the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, A to Z. The way he treated his enemies, the non-Muslims, the way he treated his own, you know, family members, his spouse, his wives, and his grandchildren and his daughters, and even the way, as I said, the way he transacted everything, you know, it comes in a collective way, the sunnah. And that's the most important thing for us, that we need to bring the sunnah, the light of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the light of guidance that he came with, into our lives. And our lives should be filled with the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we pray Allah grant us that tawfiq and ability to follow in the footsteps of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May he increase us in love for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so that in the next life, on the Day of Judgment, we are with the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Al mar'u ma'a man ahab, a person is with the one whom he loves. So inshallah, this love will make us be in the company of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah enable us to drink from the al-hawd, the pool, on the Day of Resurrection, on the Day of Qiyamah, the pool from which the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be giving water out to his followers. And may Allah not make us from those people whom it will be said that these people, they come to the pool and, you know, And the hadith has been mentioned that there'll be a barrier placed. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam will say, "These are my people." It will be said to him that, "No, these people, you don't know what they did after they turned away from your ways." And they will be turned away from the hawd, the pool. May Allah protect us from that. And may He not make us from those people. Inshallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم.